Hey everyone, in today's video I want to talk about an AWS service called EC2 Instance Connect Endpoint. It's a pretty new solution. I mean, it's been announced nearly a year ago, but still not many people are aware that it exists. So I wanted to show how we can use that Instance Connect Endpoint, that service, so we can securely access our servers. So first of all, what it is for? What does it resolve? When we were creating our servers, we could only access them from remote location, like our laptop at home, let's say. We could only access them because of the fact that we chose in networking settings option to have public IP assigned. So we could then run a command on our laptop like SSH Marek at whatever. And it worked because if a server has public IP address, it will work because public IP addresses are available from anywhere in the world. The problem is that we do not always want to assign that public IPs for our servers. Sometimes we don't want to expose our servers to anybody else except of us. So there were solutions for that. One of the solutions was to use Bastion. And till now, it's still valid working solution. And for those that don't really know how that Bastion or Jumpbox solution works, we simply have to build yet another server. We usually call it, as I said, Bastion or Jumpbox. And that server will be configured with public IP address. And then we can jump through that box to access our server that is behind it, and it has only private IP address. So if our private server has private IP of 10.10.10.10, let's say, and our Bastion has public IP of, let's say, 99999, only nines, and if we have user Marek, for example, configured on both of them, and if we have SSH key working, then we can use a command like ssh-a-j, but j is to jump through something, and then I can specify the username and IP address of the Bastion, and then again username and IP address of the private server that is behind it, and this way we can jump through that first box with a public IP to reach the second box that does not have public IP, but they will communicate using private IP addresses. I mean, and this kind of works, but that means that we have to pay for two servers now instead of one, and it also means that this Bastion or Jumpbox server is exposed to all kind of attacks we can think of. So that's why AWS came with a direct replacement solution for that Bastion type of access. And they said, you know what, you can create that EC2 Instance Connect Endpoint service, and then you can use your access key and secret access key to be able to jump through that endpoint service, as if it was your Bastion. And that's perfect for us, because we already created our access key and secret access key in previous material, and the link to that video should be displayed now. So maybe now let's jump to our AWS console, and we will set up the endpoint, and we'll see exactly step by step how it works, so you can follow and set it up yourself. So first of all, I'm in EC2 console. As you can see, I have no instances, so let's create quickly one. But this time with no public IP. So doesn't matter what's the name, I will just call it Marex. Can I use Ubuntu? Instance type T2 Micro, as it's free tier eligible. We configured that a few times in previous videos, so you can go back and watch those if you have never configured EC2 instance in AWS console. The key pair, we still have that Marex key, we can use that. The only difference here is that auto-assign IP is enabled, auto-assign public IP. So we will edit that, and the auto-assign we will do disable now. So we will not have public IP address. Okay, and the rest is fine. We just launch instance. We'll wait for a few seconds. Oh, already done. So if you go to that instance now, we can see, I know it's pending, but we can see there is no public IPv4 address. Even if I refresh or click this box to see all the details, you can see private IP address, but there is nothing in public IPv4 address. So now if I wanted to connect, this command will not work from my laptop because I can't reach that private IP address. I mean, I can prove, but... So here is the private key, and if I paste that command, and press enter, nothing will happen because my laptop will not be able to reach IP address that is private and not public. So I will control C that. We will need that intermediate step, that replacement of Bastion. We could use, you know, we could create another server as a Bastion, but today we'll concentrate on that alternative solution from AWS. So where we have to go to VPC. VPC is isolated cloud resources, as you can see, virtual private cloud. This is the service that we need right now. And by the way, that VPC and those subnets were created for us by Amazon. We haven't got our own yet, but it's possible to create your own, as you can see, create VPC. What we really need here is the endpoints. We click on those endpoints on the left side, and as you can see, no endpoints found. And we have to create one. Create endpoint, and the type is EC2 Instance Connect Endpoint. And I can name it if I want. It's optional, but it will be Marek Endpoint. And I have to pick the VPC, but I have only one, so the default that Amazon created. We can see default. I believe the security groups we can omit, and we can pick the subnets where we want that endpoint to be created. Any subnet we will pick here, it will work for us anyways. It's only sometimes if you already have some instances. Well, okay, let's do it properly. Let's go back to those instances. I click that instance again. And I can see availability zone 2C. I know we haven't talked about it yet, but I will see the subnet. It's finishing with 591. So I will pick the same. This one finishes with 591. And now I can create that endpoint. It took only a few seconds and it's up and ready for us. So what we can do now, I will go to my terminal, maybe clear that, make it bigger. First of all, we need pretty recent version of AWS CLI. So if I run AWS version, as you can see, I am on version 2.15.24. But what I'm really interested in is if I have AWS EC2 Instance Connect, if I will have open tunnel option available. And I can check it by running help. So it's AWS Instance Connect help. And I can see available commands open tunnel, because we will tunnel through that EC2 Instance Connect endpoint. And if you have older AWS command line interface installed, you will not have this option available. So you simply have to install newer one. I will quit. And now I can try to connect to my instance going through that endpoint service. So let me maybe go back here. So let's go to instance. Let's copy that command again. I know we've just run it, but and it didn't work, but we will now add something else. I will type -o proxy command equals, and now it will look awful, but we will streamline it later on, so ignore it for now. So proxy command will be AWS EC2 instance connect, and now open tunnel. That's why we needed that newer version of AWS CLI, because we need that open tunnel option. And now what we need is instance ID and the ID of the instance we want to connect to. And we've got it here. That's the instance ID. All right, we'll paste it here. That has to be in quotation marks, by the way. And now we press enter. And as you can see, it takes us straight to our instance. If I run DFH. Yes, that's a gig disk that I've got available. And as you can see, .11.186, that is .11.186. That's the private IP address of our server. So we can now tunnel through that EC2 Instance Connect endpoint to reach our server that does not have public IP. But let me exit from here. And you know what? That command, it looked awful, didn't it? Let me control C. Maybe I will clear that. So I will show you how to make it look much better. If we go to our, if we use tilde, that's our home directory. My home directory, home parallels. We've got here the .ssh folder. If I go there, cd.ssh, I should have some files here. All right, I've got something, but I will add a new one. It will be called config. So I will create one, vim config. And here I can configure how I want to SSH to basically anything really. So I will put host. You will see in a minute what I mean. Host, I can call it whatever. Let's say XYZ. User, I will need all those details that AWS already provided. So user will be Ubuntu. I will copy that. Host name, that will be our IP address. What else do we need? We need our SSH key, I can put here identity file, SSH calls it, and I have to specify the path to my SSH key. So it was in my home directory in downloads, and what it was called? So downloads, you can see home downloads, marex underscore key dot pen. Yeah, something like that. And the last thing, it's not here, but that was actually the longest part. It was that proxy command. So I can proxy command, I can use that configuration here as well. It was AWS EC2 instance connect. It was open tunnel because we had to tunnel through that EC2 instance connect endpoint. And the instance ID was the thing we also needed, is this. Oh, by the way, sorry, because I go any further. As you can see, no public IPv4 assigned. With no IPv4 address, you can't use EC2 Instance Connect. Alternatively, you can try connecting using EC2 Instance Connect Endpoint. Look here, this is the service that would let us connect to our server as well from the AWS console. And this is the identifier of our EC2 Instance Connect Endpoint. So there are two different things, EC2 Instance Connect and EC2 Instance Connect Endpoint. But we don't want to connect using AWS console, we are connecting from my laptop. So I will just copy that instance ID, but it's worth to mention as well, yes? All right, but I will just paste it here. That's my instance ID. And now I can escape colon WQ, write and quit, enter. So now if I do cat config, this is what we configured. And now I should be able to SSH using just that name that I provided. It can be whatever you need, but I called it XYZ. So let's try now. As you can see, it takes us to our instance as well. But this time we don't have to type that very long, awful command. All right, that's really all I wanted to say about that service. Just wanted to mention, remember to always remove that instance. When you stop playing with that, just go back to the instances and just terminate it, okay? So it doesn't cost us any money. And regarding that endpoint, we can leave it here. It doesn't cost us anything anyways, so it can be there. Okay, that's it. See you in next episode. Bye.